A new relationship with the earth is established in modernity, one which does not simply consist of a productive system that intensifies natural production in order to direct it to human needs, but which also reduces all natural processes to the accumulation of available, usable, and consumable resources. This conversion of the earth into matter and energy produced a radical separation between a plastic, demiurgic humanity and the earth, reduced to an object of demolition and depredation, a transformational project that generated waste and debris of all kinds. The purpose of thinking in a planetary perspective is not that of abandoning the earth, of evacuating it, to return it to its sidereal errancy. Thinking is not an extraterrestrial event. It rather reflects passages, transformations, deformations, captures, participations, possessions, colonizations. Assuming modes of life beyond the conservative and economical model of the organism gives to philosophy a chance for thinking of a plurality that does not multiply the singular, but individualizes instead a common dispersion.
So I'll start with the idea of a plurality that individualizes a common dispersion. I've been thinking through a version of this idea in terms of our perceptions and representations of planetary expression in what I've been calling an experience without authority. Experience without authority refers to the collective deliberation over the meaning of planetary reality, a deliberation that constitutes the very appearance and understanding of that reality. So I'm questioning the extent to which we perceive in ways that are co-determined with planetary expressions and with other perceivers. So I pursue the idea of a collective deliberation in order to register the active and even creative dimension of perception itself alongside interpretation through the faculty of understanding, which for Hannah Arendt is engaged and liberated precisely through collectivity. But of course, when I think of collectivity, I'm also referring to other beings, other epistemologies, other species, the other writ large, me, you, us, them. So the experience without authority implicates a multidimensional, multi-perspectival, multi-being mode of experience. Understanding of our planetary reality doesn't come from the disciplining of knowledge then, neither from the life sciences nor social or political sciences. Instead, an experience without authority lies in the very event in which authority has been eclipsed by an infinitely open questioning and interpretation of the planetary reality that experience confronts. So my emphasis on without authority per se is also, as you described, to think about anarchism and the anarchism of experience. On the one hand, I'm gesturing toward the predicament in which we are experiencing the earth in a so-called post-truth era. So a moment characterized by the exhaustion of criticism, the exhaustion even of philosophical concepts, but also a struggle with that exhaustion as an integral part of the anarchism of experience. So a recognition that the earth breaks into our thinking, disassembles it, refuses assimilation, and in this refusal is incorporated within as a trauma, or what Negrestani calls a geotrauma. To my mind, the geotrauma to perception that the earth presents, the irreducible earth that perturbs and demands, this raises the question of how we must also be experiencing non-experiences, deprivations, or other negatives of our era. For example, how are we experiencing ourselves, our environments, others, the earth, in and through extinctions, ongoing colonial violence, necropolitics? So, and finally, to get to the original problem, how does the experience of the totalizing privation of life in and as a kind of planetary necrosis impact our understanding of the future? So it seems to me that part of the problematic of thinking the planetary future arises from the fatalism of entropy, as Bernard Stiegler has argued. Energic exhaustion intervenes on the reticulation of thought, so thinking the past, and prefaces our future thinking, the protension of thought. The framing of the future in fatalistic terms as bound to an entropy-driven planet. This is also the grounds for critique by Indigenous scholars who argue that the dystopian view of climate crisis entirely effaces the ongoing history of colonial violence that Indigenous people and their established webs of life and meaning have already confronted and are living with as a present reality. So the dread of an apocalyptic future is actually a reenactment of a fantasy of the violent claiming of land under the pretense of wilderness or frontier. So fatalism about entropy is an enabling concept, part of an imaginary that spurs the desperate claiming of land, now in the name of ecological redemption. What settlers like myself might try to come to terms with is that this very crisis, the taking responsibility for damaged land and history, while at the same time embellishing on the precarity of Indigenous people, in fact reifies a fantasy that our settler ancestors were actively driven toward. So the propulsion of ecological crisis onto the future as the very event of the future forcefully insists on the linear movement of time from a stable past to a planetary catastrophe in the future. But this entire temporal modality effectively cancels generational models of time, as well as the relations that are built into Indigenous webs of life. So if there's a reckoning to be done here, it's to think about how our experience of the planet is charged by the geotraumas of extinction. So a non-relationality that is dogging us as the negative of the Greek concept of physis, the blossoming of vitality, now presenting itself as the planet's withdrawal of life from human experience. But it's also how to cultivate a sensibility and responsibility for that experience in and through collective struggle, without relinquishing to the authority of science, but instead in and through deliberation over the meaning of that experience. So it's important here to think about the allyships and ways of being an accomplice to an anarchical experience of the planet, to take Indigenous political struggles as a central part of that anarchical experience, while dismantling fantasies of entropy-driven, of a death-driven entropy.